Okay, after a lengthy intermission there, they fixed the lane. Okay, so what I was trying to do here, I'm going back to my purple axis, and based on that last shot, I think I can stand on 7 and go up 7. Kind of tighten it up a little bit. Let's see what happens. Uh-oh. Oh, what's that? Yeah, I dropped it and pulled it and did a lot of bad things. And you can see the result. Okay, let's try this again. All right. Let's try that again and not make such a terrible shot. Okay, so purple axis. Also at 3,000, by the way, just to let you know. 3,000 grit. I'm going to go stand on 7 and go straight up 7, hopefully, right? With a nice, smooth shot. Here we go. There. What's wrong with that? Apparently nothing. Apparently nothing is wrong with that. That's a really great ball, by the way. I used that ball at Nationals. I think it was in 2021. And that was the only ball I used on the team event. And it was like really, really consistent and kept me in the pocket, let me make my spares. And actually, it was a little nerve-wracking because on my first game on team pattern on Nationals, I couldn't get a strike. Every single shot, I left something and I made it. And at the very end of the game, I had a clean game of spares. Isn't that ridiculous? All right, let's try one more with it. I was like, I was gonna have a nervous breakdown. It was so scary. All those spares. Okay, let's try to float it up to 7 again. What's that gonna do? I went a little high. I missed a fraction inside and it went a little high. I mean, that's what you would expect, right? But let's get back into resin. All right, let's see the differences here. All right, so let's, just for the heck of it, I know it's futile. I'm bringing the pro motion back out. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna make the same shot I just made with that purple hammer with the pro motion. I'm gonna try to just float it up 7. Just even see if it does anything. There, floating it right up 7. Look at that, it doesn't even move. You see that? It just goes perfectly straight. That ball is not for house shots. Let me just put it to you that way. It expends its, it's at 3,000 grit, and it still expends its energy so fast that it really can't do anything. It's like useless, honestly. All right. Let me try something radical with this thing. Okay, so I'm gonna stand, what am I gonna do here? I'm gonna stand on 15 with my foot, and I'm gonna target like, I don't know, 12, something like that? Yeah, how about 12? Just gonna roll it 12 area, see what happens. Yeah, what's that gonna do? What's that gonna do? It's gonna do nothing. So the pro motion is like, it's so useless. It's like a spare ball. And obviously leaving scrap like that. So that ball, it's really amazing how terrible that ball is on this cow shot. I just don't get it. Alright, let's jump back, standing on 12. Targeting 7, got the informer. Let's get back to the stuff that seemed to be working. Look at that. Wow. Okay, well that's, wow, is it gonna keep going? What's going on here? Yeah, that's a bad shot. A bad shot. And a bad result. Which is what you normally get when you make a really bad shot. So even the informer couldn't save me that time. All right, let's try to make a better shot. Again, I'm standing 12, trying to get it to about 7, and maybe inch it out to 6 board and get it to recover. Here we go. What about that? Oh God. Wow, it almost stayed up. That 7 almost stayed up. Okay, I got it too far out. Again, it only left 1 though. That's a really good result, right? Okay. So, let's think about this now. I'm standing 12, targeting 7 with the informer, trying to get the ball. No further right than 6. That's a good shot. Wow. Again, I got 9, but you can see the informer stripping the oil off the lane, man. So now it is going crazy. Definitely going crazy. And so what do you do when that happens? Well, you move, right? Isn't that what they tell you? They tell you in the world of resin play that when your ball is getting to the point you had it to before and now it's going high, you need to move your feet left and maybe even your target left. So normally they say like a 2-in-1 move. Can I make a 2-in-1 move with such a low rev rate? Let's find out. So I'm standing on 12, now I'm going to 14 and my target's going to 8. This is like way inside out. I never play like this. Oh, left the 10. It was like a half 10 too. So it kind of rang, kind of. So that's telling me that I moved too far left with my foot. If I move back one board, perhaps that'll get the 10 out. All right, let's try to get that 10 out. All right, so let's move back that one board. So now we're going to 13. Targeting, wait, where am I out here? Wait, hold on. All right, 13, there it is. I was standing in the wrong spot. I was like, wow, why am I way over here? All right, here we go. Uh-oh, that's way out there. And I got 9 again. Wow, I need to use this ball for a no-tap tournament. Yeah, I missed right, as you saw. And it still came back, and it almost went high, honestly. I mean, it was high, it almost... All right, let's try to make the spare. We'll just target the second arrow. Uh-oh. No, barely. Yeah, I kind of missed left. All right. So let's try that shot again. We are standing on 13, targeting 8, and allowing the ball to float a little bit out to the right. So let's do that. So here we go. Standing on 13. Looking at 8. There, that's what I wanted. Well, it's a strike. Come on. That's bullshit, man. How can that be a strike? These damn cheater balls. That's crazy.
That is crazy.
All right. That was not that great a shot, by the way, obviously. Let's try it again. So we're standing 13,
targeting 8, trying to float it up to 7.
All right. Got a little further right, and you saw the result, just overreacted. But it still left something makeable, right? It still left something not too bad. So the ball will overreact if I get it too far right. At least we know that, right? Blink. Okay. Let's try another shot with this Informer. This is like a different world for me, people, because I never use resin, and I definitely never am standing this far left and throwing that far right. That's kind of crazy, actually. I'm curious what the limits of this ball are, but let's just make the same shot I was making. I'm going to stand 13, targeting 8. Trying to get it no further right than 7, but having some difficulty. Maybe. Yeah, that's really good. Okay, this is getting silly. Very silly. All right, let's try something different. What if I move a zone left with this ball? I'm getting a little brave. But, you know, when you have 11, 12 mile per hour ball speed with 135 RPMs and you're a full roller, usually moving in and throwing around the lane ain't something you normally do. So what I'm gonna do now is, I think I will stand, and let me look here and see what I wanna do here. I'm gonna stand 17, and I'm gonna target 12. Whoops. What the hell? I dropped the ball and it double tapped the 10 and struck. What the hell? That was like a terrible shot. And yet, absurd. All right, let's try this again. All right, here we go. Standing 17, targeting 12, and trying not to drop the ball and see what happens. Okay, that is what I normally expected, right? That's what should have happened, where nothing happens, right? But I'm curious why the first shot, because I dropped it, was able to dig in and roll. Maybe because I threw a little more up the lane. So let's try that. This is all experimental waters for me, people. I mean, I don't know what I'm doing with this ball. Actually, why are those pins still there? Reset. Okay. So I'm going to stand 17. I'm going to target, I'm going to probably be like 13, right? And I'm going to be more straight up the lane, nice and slow. Uh-oh. Yeah, that's not going to work. Dropped it again. Bad shot. All right, let me get this out of the way. Okay, so let's try that again. 17 going up 13, a nice, smooth, straight shot. Here we go. Very far inside. There. Crap. Boink. Nah. Okay, that's now I know the limitations of the ball. That's fine. Okay, let's go back to what we thought was the optimum thing, which was, what was it again? I was standing on 12, targeting 8. That's what it was. 12, 8. That's what I wanted. Point. Wow, almost a 5-7. But something pulled the string on the 5. That's good. But this ball just hits the pocket, doesn't it? Really hits them hard, too. It makes a loud crack. Okay, now we're going to have a showdown. Resin versus urethane. I'm standing 12, targeting 8 with the informant. Go. There you go. That's a strike. I guess that's a strike. I say that's a strike because in a urethane world, that's a really bad hit. The way it just like slapped the pins, it would have left some disaster if it was urethane. Okay, so now let's go to urethane. Purple axis. So I'm going to jump back to 7. Standing 7, targeting 7. Look at that. So, question. Which of those did you like better? Which one of those shots looked better? I don't know. Let's go back to the informer and see what other kind of miracles it can form. Obviously, it's keeping me out of a lot of trouble. All right, so... All right, so I'm going to jump back to 12 with my foot, targeting 8 with the informer. Here we go. Well, what's it going to do? Wow, that is not a good result. That thing jumped like a mad ball. Okay, so maybe that's the bad thing about resin, right? If you get it in the wrong spot, it can go crazy, like you just saw. Really? 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 Oh, nope. I thought I was going to get it. Okay. So, informer left a disaster. Let's go back to the purple hammer with axis layout. Once it comes back for my spare shot. All right. And now, let's see. I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to stand... When I stood 7 and rolled 7, it kind of went a fraction high on that strike. So I'm going to move my foot a half board left. So now I'm standing on 8.5, targeting 7. Maybe. Yeah. This is really good. So does that look better? Or are you liking the informer better? Let's go back to the informer. I mean, with the urethane, I mean, the informer is helping the purple hammer because it is stripping oil off, and I'm not getting a lot of carry down problems that I would, if I was just throwing urethane, it would start getting tricky, but I'm not. So now let's go back to 12, targeting 8 with the informer. Maybe. Oh God, nope. Yikes. Still got 9 though. Yeah, the informer's running out of room here. It is such a strong, dynamic ball that you really got to get left and throw right with it to have any hope. But you can see that the purple hammer is very controlled. It's like you don't really have to do much to keep it in the pocket. All right, so now I'm gonna move another board left with my foot and keep the target the same. Let's see if that's enough. So I'm standing on 13, targeting 8. What's that gonna do? It just went high. So that one board move with my foot was just not enough to hold it off at all. That's how crazy this ball is. As the oil's going away, I'm being forced further and further left. So I'm gonna move my target. I guess what I gotta do, right? So I was standing 13, targeting 8. I'm gonna target 9, keep it more in the oil. I'm not gonna get as far out. Uh-oh. And I got 9. No, I did not hit 9. I missed way far out. Way far out, and the ball overreacts. But once again, it's still giving me 9 on every shot, pretty much, unless it's really, really bad. So let's try the Informer one more time. I'm just trying to get re-lined up with this thing, because it is pretty crazy. All right, standing 13, targeting 9. Here we go. That's better. Go. Oh, come on. Really? That was a good shot. Was it really that high? Did I deserve that? I don't know. I don't know. But you can see now the resin ball is putting me in a area of the lane where I'm forced to really get the heck over there. So now let's jump back to the urethane ball. So I'm going back to the purple hammer. I'm going to stand on 8.5, targeting 7. I'm just gonna float it up the lane. Nothing fancy. Just like that. Look at that. Now, do you like that better? Or do you like what you're seeing with the Informer? Or do you kind of like both? I don't know. To me it seems like the Purple Hammer is like a simpler shot, right? You just kind of stand over there, roll it right up the lane, and then it just kind of goes in there and strikes. Let's try that again. So let me wipe the ball down. All right, this Purple Hammer's at 3,000. It has the pin right in the axis, so you can see how the thing floats. I'm going to stand on 8.5 and just ease it up 7 with not much effort. I mean, I even missed a little inside and it still held. So, I mean, that's a really good look, right? Now let's go back to the Informer. I'm not doing that with the Informer. I gotta get left. So I'm gonna move to 14 with my foot, targeting 9. So I moved even more left. There, whoops. That's, wow, what the, come on. Those cheater balls, man, they even cheat on bad shots. Okay, obviously I was too far left now. Too far left. So when a ball pushes you so far left, in fact, let me just test that again. So here we go. We're gonna stand on 14, and I'm gonna try to hit 9 this time. That was kind of 10, but let's just see if I can get to the pocket. There, that might have been a strike. That might have been a strike. So I got a little further right, So I think, you know, again, I'm learning resin, so this is kind of the key for me, right? Try to figure it out. I move my feet left and I keep throwing right. So this ball has the ability to recover, so let's do that. So here we go, standing 14. Just like way over here. And I'm going to target like 8.5, maybe. Right out to there and back. Oh, come on. It lost too much energy. But I got 9. So I guess that's what I'm trying to say here is the Informer was really good when the lane was fresh because I didn't have to have such extreme angles. I'm still able to hit the pocket fairly consistently, but it's just, it's starting to become a lot of work, right? Meanwhile, I can use the, so let's try this Red Widow. This is also a 3000. I'm gonna stand on 8 and throw it up 7. Let's see if this one will float like the way the Purple Hammer does. Wow. I missed a little inside and that baby floated. Floated nice. Let's try that again. Let's try that again. I didn't think that was a very good shot. And those pins seem to think otherwise. So, all right, let's wipe it. Go. And stand 8, go right up 7. Let's try this again. All right. Standing 8, going right up 7. What's it gonna do? Oh, boom. Okay, now it's gonna leave a bucket. I did miss inside. And that is what you would get with urethane if you missed inside. I'm sure the Informer on that same shot would have done something much different. Much different. All right, now how do you make a spare like this? What do I want to do here? I want to stand 5 over here. And I'm basically aiming at the 8 pin. Come on! Oh, I got it. Not a very good shot, but I got it. All right. Let's try one more with the Red Widow. Okay, so I'm gonna stand 8 and float it up 7 with the Red Widow. Let's see what she does. There you go, that's what I wanted. And a perfect, perfect hit. A perfect hit. So I think throwing the Informer helped the urethane balls be better because now I've stripped a bunch of oil off up on the outside and these balls are getting a good, smooth, even read front to back and they're doing their urethane thing. So let's try that again. I'm going to stand 8, float it up 7. Just see what we get. It's a little further out. Will it matter? Yeah, it will matter because it burns up. It burned up and it left the tent. And that's a normal urethane result. You get it too far out. It loses a little too much energy, and wait, where did my tin can go? What the heck? Okay, the lane break again. Uh-oh. All right, stand by.